Well, that's just down the road. Came up,
you can add hours.
Now, only get $15 a year.
Yeah, phone there. Holding the phone and dry.
I think it's like ripping on the 40 acres of a mule here.
That looks good.
There they are.
Over there. Yeah, I stood in the room.
I know. You came out about a million.
Why are you guys here today?
Oh, you talk.
Go ahead.
We're here. This is the third year in a row we've been at a Walmart. We were at one in Piscataway. 2 years ago, last year we were at New Brunswick. This year we're here. And we're committed to trying to get Walmart to provide higher wages. It's becoming part of the public awareness now that the middle class is being eroded because of the wages are going down so much.
Well, the workers here were never really middle class, right?
The workers at Walmart, yeah, they've never been middle class, but this affects everybody. If you start the lowest people at very low, then the people that are rung up are just almost as low. So the rungs just don't get higher.
And the workers should make enough so they don't have to get food stamps in order to live.
Now,
and
why
they don't have to get charity.
So why is it that there's a situation like this in this country where people who work like 40 hours a day can't make a living?
Because the top 1% have stolen all our money.
Deborah Zukowski said you don't work here.
Right there.
Is that correct?
That's correct. Don't work here.
So do you work at any of the Walmart?
No. No, it's, you know, I work, the Waltons are in my pocket. Waltons are in all of our pockets. The Waltons, the richest family in the world, and the biggest, probably the world's largest retailer, they don't pay their people a living wage. They refuse to pay their people a living wage. So causing the HR department in this store and every other Walmart facility teach their new hires, since they're going to be working at the poverty level if they have a family, teach their employees how to get federally subsidized housing, how to access health care through Medicaid, because they can't afford the benefits that Walmart provides at a pretty significant cost relative to their salary. They teach them, they instruct them on how to get into SNAP, into the food stamp program. So they can, you know, and they're proud of the fact that they have food drives for their own employees.
Cool. Yeah, that's great.
Put out food bins, so not them. You don't see the Waltons giving them a turkey or a can of pumpkin spice. They expect their other employees, I guess, who have spouses that have decent jobs, to donate food to fellow employees. When this, the richest, these billionaires, they can afford to pay a living wage. And the Walmartization of America is really what gets me here and bringing so much cheap Chinese crap into this country and driving so much business, so much manufacturing out of the country. Right here, along this stretch, this used to be known as the Miracle Mile, where there is Westinghouse was right where that PetSmart is. Westinghouse had a manufacturing facility. There was a Revlon, that empty building over there, that was Revlon. There's industry up and down this, what was once called the Miracle Mile, until Walmart led the way to teach companies how to go to China and provide them cheaper products. So here we are today, a dying middle class that Walmart is at the heart of. Walmart's right at the heart of it. And all we're looking for today is a living wage for the people who work here.
Right.
And access to organizing a union would be nice.
So how did you, I understand, I expected to see some workers out here.
They'd get fired.
They would.
They'd be fired. They can't fight for themselves. They need the jobs. That's why they work here for less than $10 an hour, $8 to $9 an hour. And they work as many hours as they can, but they won't allow them to work more than 35 hours. So, listen, it's a labor movement. We have to stick together. The middle class is dying because of corporate thugs like Walmart. And the rest of us have to get together and try to protect the middle class, grow the middle class. The middle class is shrinking.
So what are you with any organization in particular today?
Well, I'm with this group today. Today I'm with this group. A group of fine people giving up their weekend, standing out here in the cold in the interest of other people, people they don't even know.
How'd you
so I'm with this group
together?
Today.
Is it the Action Network, or do you guys meet separately?
Yeah, no, there was responded to an online petition.
Right.
And Joe and I were at a union meeting last week. And Joe said, hey, Doc, you're going there? I'll go with you. We're Teamsters. We're Teamsters. Okay. Today, we're part of this group. The rest of the time, we're with the International Brotherhood of Teamsters.
Okay, so you already have a group. I guess I'm not that familiar with. I've heard of it, the Teamsters. That's already a group.
There's 1.4 million of us in this country.
So how many people out here today are with the Teamsters?
Looks like only two of us.
Maybe the others, they've signed the online petition, or they found out about it online?
I've been down to State House. I spoke on Hutchins versus the FEC. I went down there with New Jersey PIRG, Peter Skopek, and Food and Water Watch, Lauren, what's her name? That starts with a big Petri. We did
very loosely organized a protest, like just saw it online. Said, okay, let me send an email, sign up. And speaking with with these guys.
We just bumped into each other. How many other protests are happening across the country today? Could they estimate? I heard over 1,000.
Oh yeah. There's
1,600.
Yeah,
it's stores like this. It's just a bunch of people getting together. Yo, you heard about it? I heard about it.
I see his logo. And I'm like, hey, you must be one of the people I'm looking for.
So this is just a bunch of concerned workers out here. But the organizers, North Bergen is the big one. I said a big one in Piscataway a couple years ago, but the big.
Oh, North Bergen? Okay.
Yeah.
I just typed in my own zip code in Spotswood, and this came up.
So you remember the 60s?
I'm gonna make another one. I just gotta warm up my hands for a minute.
Understandably, you're down on your knees and my
gloves. Drive over to Costco.
I got gloves on. My hands are cold. Yeah. I can't imagine what yours are like.
They get life insurance on workers.
They're great.
If they die, life insurance goes to Walmart, not their family.
I am not kidding. No, I'm not kidding. That's how bad they are. Go all corporate and combine. That'd be excellent. You should. That's ridiculous. Yeah.
You guys work hard.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
Hey, Janice, how are you? How you been?
Not working.
Good.
Just helping out.
They didn't do anything. They gave me $8,000. I put a sign up saying that they offered me my money.
My wife's.
I know.
Okay, thank you.
How you been?
You know, but they want to be in there so bad.
Okay, I'm fine.
Yeah, kind of.
Are you fighting? Bet if you are. That's you'll get more. You'll get right. More if you fight. Trust me. I just was diagnosed with cervical cancer.
Yeah.
And my attitude is, it ain't beating me, I'm beating it.
Okay, well that's good. That's great.
Yep.
That's excellent. Nice to see you.
Have a great day. Try and stay warm and keep fighting.
Okay.
Have a nice try, everyone.
I went in the store and they said,
can you ask you a question?
Sure.
Now you're saying that it's better to go to Costco than to Walmart, and why is that?
Because Walmart pays people minimum wage. They have no union. They fight the union. They don't pay a living wage. They basically end up being subsidized by the taxpayers. They pay people so little in terms of wages that full-time workers are still eligible for food stamps and for Medicaid. Costco pays a living wage. They have a union in their warehouse. We're here in an industrial area where you could have a choice between going to Walmart and to Costco. And so we're encouraging people who are here today to just keep driving, go right past Walmart.
How can Walmart get away with this when they have Costco's? I mean, that's what keeps them in business. Well, I mean, the claim could be that Walmart would actually lose their profits if they did like Costco. What's your argument on
this? Well, the fact of the matter is Costco's making lots and lots of money. It's not true. It's just that the difference in the wages are going right into the pockets of the Walton family. It's that individuals are making more money and they make up the difference. Costco's very, very profitable.
What's your assessment of the situation right now? Do you think that it's going to happen pretty soon, that there's going to be unionization at Walmart?
I think that we're getting there. I think that as people become more and more educated as to what's going on and the demands come up for the fight for $15 an hour for a living wage everywhere, that at a certain point it will roll and we'll see it everywhere.
You apparently have been doing this for a while, so what's the comment from the people you talk to typically? Is it generally positive?
So it was pretty interesting. I think that it's a wide range between an individual who bought into the story that people would lose jobs to somebody who pulled up just moments ago and said, I'm not going to Walmart anymore. I didn't know that there was such a difference. So I think it's pretty wide range, but it seems to me that Walmart's not packed today. If you take a look, this is Black Friday. I would have thought the place would be packed. There'd be a full stream of people going in, and we don't see it. The parking lot seems pretty empty. I think the message is getting out.
Well, it's still early in the morning, but have you seen, I mean, there's been protests against Walmart for a number of years now, maybe 3, 4, 5.
Yes.
Is there any evidence that Walmart is being hit by this boycott or this against it?
Well, I can tell you, I've been out at Walmart's on Black Friday for, I think, at least this is the fourth one, and I've never seen the parking lot so empty. To me, there is evidence that the message overall is getting out about Walmart, about mistreating workers, about trying to save a couple of dollars only to have it benefit the most wealthy 1%. To me, it seems to me the message is getting out.
And in the past years, there used to be, I went to the one in Secaucus a couple of years ago. There used to be a lot of police and a lot of protection, and then this year I don't see any police, and I think that when you try to get to the door, they were very polite and civil. So what do you attribute to this change?
Well, the police officer seemed pretty sympathetic.
They were
to
actually
the workers
police, or
by,
they were just security guards?
No, there were two police officers here from the Edison police. They made a very big point of saying they were union members and that they were sympathetic. And I think that the police generally are pretty sympathetic.
But thank you very much. They asked you to go away from the front of the store, I think?
They did. They asked us to move 150 feet away from the front of the store and responded to Walmart's complaint, but you don't see them here now. We've certainly moved closer. Nobody seems to be bothering us, and, you know, we're active here, and, yeah. And again, to me, this seems like a, I mean, I've been at Walmarts where there's this huge stream of people walking
I just
in.
Passed the East Brunswick store. It also looked empty. I was surprised because last night they were so jammed. I was there myself last night.
Oh, that's interesting. I didn't know that. I do know that.
I think he's right. I think it's early.
Oh, maybe that is what it is. Although, you know, there have been times where people from Black Friday sales trample each other to get in at this hour, so I'm hopeful. We'll see.
Are you planning on doing some action a little later without telling me what it is, or maybe you could?
Well, we'll just be here until we think that we'll take whatever action we think is most effective to reach people.
Yeah, that's right. The online it said that the protest was from what, 9 to 1? So, how do you know people won't come later and join you?
No, they might.
Did you get many? Are you Jane, by the way?
No, I'm not Jane.
I saw
it.
What's your name?
Janice. My name's Hetty.
Say it again.
My name is Hetty.
Hetty?
Yes.
What's your last name?
Rosenstein.
Rosenstein.
Hetty Rosenstein. I'm from CWA.
What's that?
The Communications Workers of America. We represent 70,000 workers in this state. Well, you know.
Now, Hetty, in the past, the unions were not really concerned about people who were not unionized. I mean, I don't say they were not. I think the membership, but the leadership, I mean, the workers' movement, the unionized workers' movement has been going down for many, many years. It's been a noticed phenomenon. Do you think there's a turnaround now that the union leadership is realizing that they need to recruit and increase their numbers?
Well, my union, I think, has been pretty active in terms of organizing for many years. I don't think that the labor movement can survive without organizing. I think that it may even be too late. I'm not going to kid myself that in this country, it's almost illegal to organize. But I do think that the labor movement as a whole understands that it will die if we don't organize.
Is there sort of a notice of intent from the workers at the Walmart that they want to have a union? Do they actually?
I think there are places where there are workers who are walking out today and being part of a Black Friday strike. And there are places where people are really way too fearful still. But I think one thing we know is that if you ask any workers, would you like to have a union? Overwhelmingly, people will say yes. The only time that changes is when they understand how much management will fight them. They're afraid, and for good reason, because management will fire people when they depend upon their jobs and they're afraid.
Isn't that illegal to fire somebody?
It is illegal. It's totally illegal. But they may try, and that's why we have to stand up with them. We have to make workers feel like they're not alone and that they're going to get a tremendous amount of support from everybody who cares about workers' rights.
Thank you very much, Hetty.
Hetty, why are you so...
Thank you.
Yeah, $219 for 50 inch. They had it on me.
Where's Katie's?
She's still down. She's down in AC. She.
Don't shop at Walmart. Go to Costco. Don't shop at Walmart.
Yeah, so she's in New Jersey.
Yeah, right.
Oh, okay.
So.
Tell me who you are, just your first name.
I'm Diane from Westfield.
Hi, Diane. There's an advice here that people should not shop at Walmart, I guess because they don't pay their workers well, and then Costco has unions, and I guess it's a little more acceptable. But in the grand scheme of things, is there also a message there or some sort of, not to confuse people, but that the fact that people are actually consuming so much is a problem?
Definitely. Overconsumption is a major problem, using up resources, especially they're using cheap labor from China, and a lot of goods that are, a lot of them are toxic, and I mean, then a lot of these products, a lot of the e-waste is going in and being shipped to Southeast Asia and poisoning people there. It's a bad cycle. And
so you think we should stop, or we should pay Asian workers or wherever they are more to produce the same thing, or is there just a problem with the fact that we are consuming so much? What's
both.
The angle?
Well, it's overconsumption is a huge problem. We're using more, like 2.5 Earths or something, more than that maybe, and our reach is exceeding what the Earth can sustain, and it's a huge problem. We need to do things that are more sustainable, and we should we're buying too much, and we need to recycle and pare down a little, try to live more simply, and try to buy things that are ecologically sustainably made, and more handmade things, and buy shop at like Saturday is Small Business Saturday, so people should shop and support local merchants. Keep the money in your community. A lot of the problem is if you buy in Walmart, the money is going out of your community and it's putting other small shops out of business.
Good point. I see you have a t-shirt there that's talking about a minimum wage of $15.
The 15 Now campaign, yes, that 15. Everyone should make at least $15.
Is that enough to live in this area?
Not in the New York, New Jersey area. I mean, it really should be more than that. Some places are saying they should raise it to 20 or more, but it would be a good start, because I mean, people are homeless and working multiple jobs. It's crazy.
What do people do when they make these kind of wages, like less than 15? I mean, how do they survive?
A lot of the Walmart employees have to get government benefits. They have to get food stamps, and that's, if Walmart paid them more, they wouldn't have to do that. It's ridiculous, because they're taking money out of the public treasury.
But in general, do people have to take several jobs? How do
a lot
they
of
actually?
People do. if they can find them. That's another problem that Walmart doesn't, they don't want to pay people full time, and they have a lot of part-time employees, so people have to work multiple jobs to get by.
Now, this country was supposed to be the land of opportunity, so how did we get here that people can't even make a living anymore?
It's a sad state of affairs that the corporations are doing well, they're doing fantastic, but the money's not filtering down to the middle class. I mean, Henry Ford realized you have to pay the workers a good salary so they can buy your products, and I mean, we've gotten away from that. The companies just want to make more and more profits. They want to bust unions, and the middle class is disappearing, and that's the bulwark of our society. That's, you know, that people should pay more taxes and support things like infrastructure and things like that that we need.
So you spoke about Henry Ford and how the corporations, I guess he was one of the biggest. That they actually favored paying people a decent wage, and there was a turnaround. What do you attribute this turnaround to? The fact that now corporations want to pay as little as possible.
It's a race to the bottom. They want to just, like, you know, that if one, they're all trying to compete with each other, trying to make, you know, as much profit as possible. And I mean, it used to be like a CEO made 500 times what the employee made, and now it's like over 1,000 times. It's ridiculous. I mean, there's more and more inequality.
But they're saying that it's about competition. They say it's about competition. Do you believe that?
Well, it's there. Yeah, it's a competition, but it's a competition that demeans people's lives. It's, you know, that people can't survive on. They can't afford health care. They can't afford basic. A lot of people are can't afford to even keep their homes. It's ridiculous.
So, do you think there's a political solution when all our most of the national politics is controlled by money?
Yes. So, that's a huge part of the problem. We need to get rid of Citizens United. We need to get the money out of politics. I mean, it's been known that Washington's for sale for a long, long time, and people have been warning that, and it's getting worse and worse. I mean, the McCutcheon agreement that the Supreme Court has been supporting this, and it's like we have to somehow get this. I mean, Elizabeth Warren at least is speaking out for trying to get some of the money out of politics, and Bernie Sanders talks about it. But I mean, there needs to be a public will, and we're going to have to increase taxes on the wealthy, and everybody needs to pay their share, and the poor are the ones who are paying the most taxes, because you pay sales tax. That's a regressive tax. I mean, it's very unequal, and people at the top are finding loopholes, and it's they've worked the system. They put their money in offshore accounts. They're like, you know, it's where they don't have to even pay any taxes. A lot of the wealthiest corporations don't pay any tax.
Thank you very much, Diane. Yeah. I appreciate your input.
Yes, 15 now, and dignity and justice for everyone.
Thank you. Like a sign that you want to speak, so tell me.
Number one, all the manufacturing jobs were shipped overseas, and for the last 30 years, the supposedly middle class worker, or the working poor as I would call it, has been flat waged. All the 1%ers, all the money has gone up. You see all the time, you see the charts that show that. So it's a redistribution of wealth from us to them, be it with added cost to paying for your medical bennies and your pension, that the teachers have been paying their pension and religiously, and the state is not paying their fair share, right? So they're using the money somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Secondly of all, since all those jobs went overseas, especially venture capitalists like Mitt Romney, they basically, that's what they did. They came into manufacturing facilities, took maybe the money-making part of it, sold the rest of it off. So now without those jobs here, what jobs do you have here? There's 317,000 college-educated students in this country, or ex-students in this country, that are waiting tables because there's no jobs in their fields. So something's wrong here, you know? And not only that, if in fact these are the only jobs that you are gonna have, then you damn well better pay a better wage than $8-something an hour, so that the rest of us have to subsidize people that are women with a single woman with a child, and we're paying for food stamps, and which I totally completely agree with. If you're not making the money, how are you gonna feed your children? And so they should definitely raise the wages, give some medical bennies, and do the right thing. That's as far as I'm concerned.
And what's your name?
My name is Eric.
Eric, there's some people who say that the working class in this country, unlike in other countries, made a pact with the capitalist system, you know, the corporations, so that for peace, you know, so that they would get a decent wage and and then they wouldn't fight against the system itself, you know, the capitalist system. What do you say to that?
Well, I misunderstood the question.
Okay, so I sense that you have a You feel like the working class has been betrayed by the system, by the capitalist system.
Yes.
But there are some people who say that the capitalist system was never on the working people's side, and that there was some sort of a pact that happened earlier, maybe in the 30s or the 20s, so that you know, the working class would not ask for the abolition of capitalism. And they would just work with the system as long as they were paid a decent wage. But now, obviously, I sense that there's a feeling among a lot of working class people, they've been betrayed. What do you say to that?
I absolutely, totally agree. Okay. A capitalist system is not working. A capitalist system, what you need is, you need a capitalist system with a little bit of communism in it, with a little socialism in it. You need it divided, because a capitalist, where they think that they're gonna make all the money on the sweat of whatever they developed, but the workers don't get to cash in on some of that also, that's wrong.
So you're telling to me that you can't really trust
a capitalist system.
A capitalist system.
Fully, because another reason is because all the numbers on Wall Street are manipulated. There is no true supply and demand. It's all manipulated numbers. It's false.
Mm-hmm. Do you own any stock or anything?
No, I don't.
Nothing?
No, I don't. I'm smarter than that.
So do you oversee eventually that you foresee that it is, there's a possibility that the capitalist system may be overthrown eventually if it goes on the way it does?
Yes, I do. What they have to do is realize that they have to start giving back a little bit, and that might save the whole thing. And hopefully that's on the way.
Do you think they'll be scared enough to do that, or?
That's a good question. They're pretty bold, and then they're sociopaths, as far as I'm concerned.
Have you met any of these very rich people? Have you ever actually talked to any of those people?
There's a great divide between when you start bringing up programs, you know, listen, the Bible says it, you got to take care of everybody, you know what I mean? I'm not overly religious, but you know what, you got to stop worrying about number one and start worrying about everybody as a collective. That's the way I feel.
Do you think that psychologically, if you could convince them of that, people, these 1% people, they would actually change?
That's a good question. I thought that something was going to happen with Occupy, But you see, they did the same thing they've been doing through all of history, is they used the police, the National Guard, and everyone to come and stomp them and end it all. So they're all in it together to stop it, yeah.
Thank you very much, Eric. I appreciate your insight.
Thank you very much. I appreciate giving it to you.
I'll tell you a little trick. You always want to hold it sideways if you're posting.
Oh, is she?
Yeah.
New t-shirt?
Can't see the
hair. Oh, okay. I see her.
Take a picture of it.
Thank you.
Make sure you see my UAW headband.
Nice.
You want to get close and hold the sign?
Yeah, hold the sign.
Yes. Most important.
The anatomies.
There you go.
Thank you.
Will you just stop for the picture?
Okay.
You're just stopping for the picture?
Yeah. Yeah, I take a labor class at Rutgers.
Oh, you're taking a... Okay.
Yeah. So thank you, guys.
Okay. Put your coat on.
When I swore at that guy that said it was gonna, when they were gonna.
Yes. Okay. So ladies, what are you doing here today?
We're supporting.
Oh, look at that, see?
Unions for Walmart workers and a working wage of $15 an hour.
I see the hat there. Are you a steel worker?
I am a steel worker.
Now, where is the industry here in New Jersey?
I am with the industry in New York.
In New York?
Okay, yes. Healthcare workers, New York State Nurses Association.
Okay.
Local 9544.
That's in the hospital?
Yes.
Going somewhere that they've probably been reproducing
for the staff for the nurses
millions of years.
And you're off today?
I go off today.
And what do you do on your day off?
We do union organizing, union support.
Because
we have to band together.
And we have to bring the middle class back.
Are you a steel worker as well?
No, I'm not. Right? No, I'm just an independent woman who realizes that we need to bring the unions back. When there are no unions, there's no middle class. And without a middle class, we'll be like a third world country.
There's some people who said that the unions didn't really do their work, in the past, and that they...
No, the unions did do their work. Okay. It was the government who didn't do their work.
Okay.
When Reagan fired the air traffic controllers, that was the beginning of the end. And so after that, the unions did lose their power. But prior to that, the unions gave jobs to people, benefits, pensions. The longshoremen in New Jersey, they fought. My father was one of them. For benefits with the union. And now, in the United States, they're the highest paid blue-collar workers. And that's because of their union strength and the people that fought for it.
But they're still shrinking, right? They're still shrinking.
Absolutely. We have to educate people.
Yeah.
You want benefits, you want to be able to live, and everything has gone up except our wages. And that's wrong.
Well, we must tell workers that the Koch brothers are organized against labor. Okay, and they're spending massive millions and billions of dollars against union labor, against laws and support of workers, and that is a big task, and we have to still come out every day and fight against them and those that they have bought off to fight against workers and fight against unions. So they're making laws, and everyone knows there's been laws. You know, we moved the United States, laws have been made to move back to right to work states. The National Labor Board has been compromised. There's many issues, but we know the Koch brothers are leading the struggle against organized workers.
They have the money to do it.
They have the money. Billionaires.
Do you attend your union meetings?
I do.
Are they talking about organizing drive outside or?
Our union does organize. United Steelworkers, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I was at our United Steelworkers Constitution convention this year. One of the biggest issues and resolutions was about organizing. And United Steelworkers organizes in Mexico and in Canada.
In Mexico?
Yes.
Really? How about in the United States?
Of course, United States. Yes. We have.
Tell me a couple of instances where this is happening.
Well, number one is that the United Steelworkers is in support of working wages for Walmart.
Okay.
And we're out at other locations today. Okay. We're fighting in environmental justice against the tar sands in Canada. There's many examples.
But some people would say that the pipeline would actually give people jobs, so that's a union issue as well,
right? Of course,
right?
Some people said it because people need jobs, but we also have to analyze this. What's it going to cost?
Initially, it's going to, the pipeline will give 3,600 jobs. However, later on, 35 jobs only, and that's it. And we're risking our environment for that, for 35 jobs.
And they always build it up, and they sell it to towns and states and countries that it's going to be jobs.
That's right.
Right. That's just the carrot.
So you see like sort of a turnaround. At one point, unions were just protecting jobs, no matter what jobs. But now they're willing to look at more global issues, more societal issues, poverty and things like that.
Yeah, absolutely, they are.
Yes.
You know, it's not just the workers. It's the country we live in. We have to bring our jobs back. We can't survive like this. We're a manufacturing country. Any country that gives away their manufacturing turns into a third world nation, and that's not what we're supposed to be. We're the United States of America. You know, we got to start acting like it. These people are afraid to even mention the word unions because they're desperate for jobs. But if they all stuck together, they need to learn there's power in numbers. We can organize. We have laws in place. The Taft-Hartley Act would protect you.
Mm-hmm.
But we need a labor board, and we need people to back us up.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we need, like in the old days.
So you're optimistic that this is going to happen, or?
I'm always optimistic. That's life. I was with the AFL-CIO in Honolulu. It was beautiful.
When was that?
In the 70s.
Okay.
Everyone took care of everyone. Everybody. You called a strike, the Teamsters joined you, and we had soup kitchens open for our members. It was beautiful. And everyone stuck together, and the hotel owners didn't lose a penny. They made money. Because a happy staff, you have happy clients. You get what you pay for, is the bottom line.
What's your assessment of what's going to happen with Walmart now? What's your prediction? Do you think something's going to happen pretty soon? I mean, it's been going on for a number of years now.
I think if they go back to the policies of the founder, he wanted to sell goods made in the United States. I'm sure he's rolling in his grave.
Interesting.
Because of this.
That was the father or the grandfather?
Yes.
What was his name again?
I don't remember his first name right now, but it was Walton.
Well, thank you very much, ladies, and good work on such a cold day.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Me too. Question for you.
Go to Costco instead! Don't shop at Walmart! Don't shop at Walmart!
I said to a professor one time, they said the question.
Tell me who you are.
My name is Mary Prancitelli. I'm the vice president of the Middlesex County National Work for Women.
Okay, and why is the National Organization for Women here today?
We're here to support the rights of actually equal pay. And we are here to support and for fair labor laws, you know,
okay.
Labor treatment towards these workers.
That is not a traditional activity of a national organization for women to do labor work.
Well, no, it is because actually I'm a retail worker.
Okay.
I work for Macy's Inc. And if you look at retail across the board, you'll see that retailers employ many, many women, more women than
most
industries. So, and you'll see across the board that these are some of the lowest paying jobs.
My wife goes.
So it is about supporting women. It is about supporting workers, and it is about equality for all. So it is definitely.
How's work at Macy's?
I actually work for Bloomingdale's.
Oh, Bloomingdale's.
And I have to say, probably out of all the retailers,
the Koch brothers,
they give workers the best treatment. But that's not saying that it couldn't be better.
Billionaires for Bush.
I mean, they're the best of the worst, in my opinion.
So, as far as I'm concerned.
So you retail, you're on your feet all day?
What?
Are you on your feet all day?
I'm on my feet all day, and I think there's much to be changed in retail.
Just to make it look like somebody else was in there, and then they put the other son in.
All workers who are on the selling floor, all workers who, you know, are on the bottom, all workers who need a path for a career to move up in the company for promotions.
And the next one after him is George.
So,
have you talked to any of these workers here at Walmart about what the difference between the condition you work in and what you perceive their condition is here?
Have I talked to them yet? I just got here, so, so I didn't have a chance to really talk to them. You know, like I said, I know, you know, from that this Walmart is one of the, I guess, the worst out of
this particular one.
I would say, you know, I was looking, you know, I heard even in Alabama, we have like really, really, really horrible stuff going on in Alabama. So,
At Walmart?
At Walmart. I mean,
like what? Tell me what's what you heard about
that. I mean, this is going years back, but I don't want you to quote me on this,
okay.
But I know that they were doing things like paying workers or scheduling workers for only 20 hours a week to avoid health care. So,
right.
You know, and these workers in Alabama who are a lot of women, again, and men too, all different,
but mostly
women, who a lot of these women are single parents. And, you know, basically what they're doing is really keeping them in a rut.
Right.
You know, people are starving. People are hurting out there.
They keep them in poverty.
You know, yeah, they keep them in poverty. I believe these women, sometimes they get subsidized by the government.
Right.
And basically when they do get subsidized by the government, they keep their wage low when they get these subsidies.
So what's the way out of this? For these people, I mean, is there a way out?
I think one of the biggest ways out is the Equal Pay Act. Raise the bar on minimum wage. And get strict on labor laws across the board. Pass stricter laws when it comes to retailers.
Well, the Equal Pay Act failed, didn't it? Like years ago?
Mm-hmm. And so I think what they need to do is have an act where they can do audits on all these companies and see exactly who's getting paid what.
You're asking the politicians to do this? To actually promote these kind of things when...
I'm asking to, you know, have laws in the book to enforce...
To enforce
really
what is right.
The laws of what is right for workers. Lowering their wage, paying them low, keeping them in a rut, keeping them impoverished, it's not helping the economy.
And how is that going to happen? How are you going to organize these changes in laws?
Well, things come in little bits and pieces.
Okay.
The best thing I know how to do is to get out here and stand here and protest. I mean, and I think more people need to get out here and protest.
You know what's going on? In the political parties regarding what you talked about, which is like the Equal Pay Act and things like
that. I just know that in 2012, there was the Lilly Ledbetter Act.
Okay.
And she spoke at the National Democratic Convention, Lilly Ledbetter. And so...
And who's she?
She's a woman who fought against, I think it was a tire corporation.
Okay.
It was a tire corporation. And, the whole thing is here is she won, but it's an employee has to, you know, take a corporation up on equal pay.
Right.
And so that takes a lot of confidence there, because it's intimidating to work for a company because you're afraid that you would lose your job.
Right.
So you would have to, you know, find or prove that someone else, maybe a male counterpart, is getting paid more than you. and then take it to court.
So there was a discussion at the Democratic Convention.
Yes, if you look it up, you'll look up
2012, which was
that was 2012
presidential convention, right?
Yeah, it was a presidential convention, the Democratic Convention. Mm-hmm. And if you look it up, you'll see more about it.
And the Democrats, you feel, are in favor of such a thing?
Oh, absolutely. I generally across the board, yeah.
Okay.
That they, the Democrats in general, are
Democrats.
In favor. Democrats.
Right. That they want more power for
all workers. They're for equality and equal pay.
Okay.
For
and
most
what
part.
What do you mean in your mind? What is equal pay? What does that really mean?
It means that all people.
Right.
Across the board. Are men and women, regardless of sexual orientation.
Right.
No matter who you are paid equally for the same kind of work that they do.
When you ask people, you know, how much money do you make, and they never answer. They don't want to
exactly,
say.
Exactly, and that's the problem.
That's a problem.
So it's transparency.
Right.
Transparency is
well,
the issue.
I mean, it's
and
privacy,
so you,
too. I mean, people don't want to say how much they make. How do you overcome
well,
that?
Well, employers don't want people to know how much each
the people themselves don't want to say how much they make. I'm not trying to...
I guess that's a matter of opinion. I tend to think that's more an intimidation factor, because when you work for a company, they tell you not to discuss that with
right.
each other.
Right.
So...
But when you're unionized, you know how much people
you
make.
Know exactly.
Exactly,
what
right?
Make.
Okay.
And I believe in that.
Okay, great.
Okay. Coming from the National Order for Women.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Mean it. Don't shop at Walmart. Go to Costco.
What do you even think about it?
Don't shop at Walmart. Go to Costco.
Yeah, he drives down to Costco. Right.
Don't shop at Walmart. Stuff is cheap. It breaks real easy. Stop it. It's in China. It doesn't work. Don't go